Hi, I'm Jack Moon. The Adelaide Fringe Festival is held in the South Australian capital of Adelaide during February and March. It features more than 5,000 artists, world premieres, hit shows, and new and established artists, including my special guest, a former member of Australian bands, Zoot, Mississippi, and the Little River Band. I am delighted to welcome Beeb Birtles.
Hey, Beeb.
Thank you for having me, Jackson.
Now, on Friday, the 22nd of February, you're performing at the Adelaide Fringe Festival.
That's right.
With a cracker seven-piece band.
Yes.
And you're playing songs from Zoot, Mississippi, and Little River Band.
That's correct, yeah.
Tell us a bit about the gig.
Well, I'll tell you how it came about, actually. It's quite interesting because Rob Pippin first contacted me in the middle of last year. And he was talking about me and Glenn Charrett repeating the Adelaide Symphony Orchestra thing because it was the 40th anniversary. And unfortunately, it didn't happen. And then Rob contacted me a little bit, you know, earlier this year, maybe late last year. I can't remember exactly when. And asked me whether I'd be interested in doing one night at the Fringe Festival. And I said to him, yeah, that'd be fun to pull songs from, you know, my now 50-year career.
Mm. So what are some of the songs you'll be performing?
Well, from Zoot, we'll do the Zoot's very first single, You Better Get Going. And, of course, I'd have to do, I don't really want to play this song, but I'm probably going to have to is one times, two times, three times, four.
Oh, that's a great song.
Might be a great song, but I don't really like playing it, you know. But what else am I doing? Of course, I have to do Eleanor Rigby and the Freak. So, you know, that's some of the Zoot stuff. I may have missed left. Well, I don't want to give it all away anyway.
Yeah. How do you feel headlining your own show?
Well, it's really interesting because, you know, I was there last year with for the induction into the South Australian Music Hall of Fame, and I had my good friend Barry Smith with me, who was my designated lead singer for that show, because I've always worked with lead singers, you know, Daryl Cotton and of course, Glenn Chorick. And I feel comfortable kind of coming into my own thing now where I can, you know, put a band of musicians around me and pick these songs from the various bands. And I'm excited about it. I really hope I get the opportunity to do it more.
Aside from your signature lead vocals, how did you handle taking on, songs that were sung by Daryl, Graham and Glenn?
Well, I'm not singing those songs. That's why I've got in this band, I've got three other very fine vocalists who will be, you know, one of them actually is more suited to singing like Daryl's stuff in Zoot, and the other one is more leans more towards the Glenn Chorick side, and then we also have a female backing singer as well. And what's good about that is that, you know, because Graham Goble always sang the really high parts in our harmony texture of Little River Band, a female voice will be able to sing those high parts.
Now, who's this singer?
Oh, this is Nanette Van Ryten, is her name.
Now, yeah. She's singing one of your new songs.
She is.
So tell us about that.
I wrote a song probably, I don't know, 30 years ago, and it was about my wife Donna's younger sister flew out to be with us. And she was, you know, having some difficulty with her marriage, and I wrote a song called Loving Should Be, where I put myself in her shoes and wrote it from a female point of view. So, yeah, so it's called Loving Should Be.
And we're not going to hear any tunes from your solo album, Driven by Dreams?
No, and I've thought about that. I think maybe at some future stage I'd want to do some of those songs, but I want to have the right combination of musicians around me to do that, because I think there's some excellent songs on that album.
There is. Available on iTunes.
Oh, it is, yeah. That's right. Thank you for the plug.
Yeah. And now you're playing in Adelaide, your hometown.
Yes.
You could have easily have sold out all capital cities. So why are we missing out?
Well, this opportunity just came from Adelaide. And so, you know, I guess I'm going to gauge to see how the show goes. And if I think it's a success, I'll start reaching out to people in Melbourne and Sydney and see if I can put something together, or maybe using the same band, or maybe using other musicians, I don't know.
During the 1960s and 70s,
yeah,
some great bands and musicians came out of Adelaide and South Australia.
Yeah.
Do you recall some of the friendships and rivalries?
Yeah, of course, we were great rivals of the Masters Apprentices and also the Valentines. They were probably our biggest rivals. And in particular, Vince Lovegrove from the Valentines, he was like, he didn't think Zoot were a very good band. He changed his mind in the end when we started releasing, you know, Hey Pinky and Eleanor Rigby and, you know. In fact, there's an article in Go Set where Vince says, "Zoot, you've made it," or something, you know. It was funny in those days because we were really all friends, and we used to play at places that were dances. There was never any alcohol around, but, you know, we were all teeny bopper bands, you know, Bon Scott before AC/DC, Vince, Barry in the Town Criers, Jim Keys and the Masters, you know. We were all, we all knew each other, but we all did our own kind of music. And we'd all play in different dances all over town, you know. Yeah, those were great days. I really liked them. Yeah. I'm glad I experienced them.
Beeb Birtles is such a cool name.
Yeah.
Who is responsible for that, Jim?
Oh, God. Well, you know, during my high school years, for some reason, my friends started calling me BB Eyes. And it was a character from the Dick Tracy Show. That was a cartoon that was on TV around those days, and that got abbreviated to BB. So all through my high school years, I was called BB, and then I think it was probably Daryl Cotton that abbreviated that to Beeb, and then I shortened my Dutch name of Bertelkamp down to Birtles and anglicised the spelling. That's how Beeb Birtles came about.
Well, that worked out pretty good. You could have been called Jerry Birtle.
Yeah, that's right.
All right, so the Adelaide Fringe Festival is 31 days of open access music, arts and performances, venues, alleyways and pop-ups. And fans of Zoot, Mississippi and the Little River Band can catch Beeb Birtles and his fantastic seven-piece band on Friday the 22nd of February at the Grand Central in Angus Street. I might see you there.
Yeah,
Beeb Birtles,
yeah.
Thanks for coming in.
I hope you do make it. That'd be great.
Great.
Yeah. Day of my life, I can surely see.